Hey Vision family, this is Chris and
Jenny.
Jenny, and Jenny, who are you?
I'm the kids director here at Vision.
Awesome. And what we decided to do is, are you excited about Sunday?
I'm so excited.
Tell
about
everybody
Sunday.
What it is.
So this Sunday we are regathering for the first time in so many weeks. We've missed you all so much. June 28th. Reunite.
Yeah, 10 o'clock, we're gonna be in this building, and some of you are kind of wondering, should we come? What are they doing to make sure we're safe? And so what we thought we'd do is give you a walkthrough of kind of what we're doing to the building, and also some things to expect, some different things. And so yeah, you ready? You ready?
Let's go.
Okay, here we are outside the building, and the first thing you're gonna notice is we're gonna use one entrance. Our kids' facility is not gonna be open yet. We are just going to be in the main worship center. And so yeah, make sure wherever you park, you'll see people on the outside waving at you. These are our greeters. Look at Jenny waving. And so they'll be there, they'll have masks on and gloves. And some of the questions is, should you wear a mask? We're gonna have masks for you if you want those. We encourage you to wear a mask. Our city, our mayor, our governor, they're encouraging us to wear masks. So if you're comfortable with that, wear a mask. If not, it's okay to come as you are. And yeah, but there we are. And so here's a thing. We're not gonna be giving any high fives. Nah. We're not gonna be giving any hugs. Nah. Okay. What we are gonna be giving is a whole lot of these. Okay. Maybe some of these. Right? Jenny likes some sound effects. You know, for you, nonchalant, you can give the head bob. Any other ways to greet Jenny that you can think of?
Well, one way is always tried and true is the wink.
The wink.
Yeah, we all like to
the wink. Be careful who you wink at. It may be interpreted the wrong way, but we're going to have greeters, and our doors will be open. You won't have to touch anything while you're entering Vision. So let's come on. Let's go inside.
So you may notice a few changes when you arrive into our welcome area at Vision. First thing you might notice is that our connect room door is closed. Now, on an ordinary Sunday, this room would be open for visitors. We would have coffee available, and it's also a place where you can go to connect. You can sign up to be baptized or join a life group. However, we have put all of these on the Vision app, so you may want to download that before you even arrive here to worship with us. Another thing you may notice is that we're going to have hand sanitizer stations available right here in the welcome lobby as well as the worship center. So feel free to use those as you need them. Also, our restrooms here in the welcome lobby will be monitored, and we just ask that you go one at a time or just a few. We will have greeters here monitoring that and helping you along that way.
Okay, we're in our worship center and you're gonna notice some changes. And let me just say this, our teams have been working really hard, and there's currently people here working really hard to clean, but not only clean, to improve our quality of service both in gathering and also online. And so you're gonna notice that the stage looks different. There's some different elements there. The lighting looks different. There's just a lot of different things to make our services look more appealing and more attractive, and to enhance and improve the quality of service. Also, you're gonna notice our seating. Now, we've got some seating arrangements, and it's a little different, so watch this. If you come to a section of seating that is taped off, we don't want you to play limbo or hurdle. We want you to avoid that section right there. And so we go to our next section, and now we've got plenty of seating right here for you, your family, probably up to five, maybe six people, depending on how close you like to sit to each other. Right, Jenny? Okay, and then you come to the next section, it's blocked off. That way no one's sitting in front of you or behind you. So we hope this helps for your safety and to give you a sense of peace as you can worship freely, because we're excited about Sunday, I'm gonna tell you. You'll also notice there's no printed material in your seats. We're not gonna have paper bulletins. We're doing everything on our app and electronically. So I encourage you, if you don't have it already, get the Vision Baptist Church app. It has so many resources available to you and things that you will use and your children will use during the service as well.
So, you may be wondering, what do I do with my kids on June 28th when we regather for Reunite? Well, we have a couple different options for you. The first option is we will have busy bags right here at this welcome table in the lobby for your kids to pick up. These busy bags will have coloring sheets, crayons, things in there to keep them occupied during the service. And guess what? Your kids can take them home with them. Everything in it is theirs to take home. Another option would be for your kids to bring their tablets. We provide a Vision Kids online worship experience for three different age groups, and we would love for your kid to bring their tablet and their headphones, and after the music, they can just tune Pastor Chris out. Listen to their service and have just an amazing experience right here in our worship center.
Another change that you're going to notice is the way that we give. Let me say this, Vision, you have been amazing, and we have seen our online generosity increase week after week after week. A lot of you are giving to this ministry. Some people who are plugged in online who've never set foot, and they're contributing to the work of God and what's happening here. And so I just want to say thank you for that, and we want you to continue doing that. If you haven't begun online giving, I really encourage you, again, download the app. Another reason, it's right there, it's simple, and doesn't take a lot of time. But if that's not for you, then we have ways to give here. And one of the ways, and it's a new way, is that we now have drop boxes. And you'll notice there's two of them right as soon as you enter the worship center. And you can just drop in your tithes and offerings. You could drop in prayer requests or anything you want there, within reason, of course. But it's just another way to keep us safe and to be mindful of everyone. The question is, when do we do this during our service? We're not passing plates anymore. We're really taking precautions. And so here's when you can give, whenever. You can give before you get here. You can give during the service electronically. But as soon as you walk in, you can drop in your tithes and offerings before the service ever stops. At the end of the service, if you want to give on your way out, you can do that. But we are going to have a different way to go out, and that's what we want to show you now. At the end of our worship experience, you may want to leave the way you came. Try again. At the end of our worship experience, you'll notice there's two exits, one to the left of our sanctuary and one to the right. Don't worry, our doors will be open. So once again, you don't have to touch anything. And there's our greeter, waving you out after an amazing Sunday experience. Well, that's it.
That's it.
That's it. I know a lot of people will be excited to see each other and want to talk and congregate. Where should they do that?
Well, as you exit out the building, we have a beautiful parking lot that is ready for you to mingle and chat and talk to each other. So we just ask that as you leave, leave those conversations for outside.
Yeah.
and visit with each other and stay as long as you want.
Yeah.
We'll be leaving because Chris has offered to pay for lunch for our family, and I'm sure he's going to invite you to.
Okay. Well, there it is, open invitation. Hey, I did want to give you one announcement that is kind of a big deal. I'm not sure if you're aware of how much work and training and preparation it is to produce an online worship experience for you and your family. And I'm just going to tell you, I know that I've received tons of texts and messages just saying how grateful people have been that they can watch online and at 10 o'clock, and it's been really good. And like we've told you, we understand that the online ministry is probably the number one way to reach people. And we want to make sure that continues with excellence, with quality. One thing that takes is volunteers. Another thing is preparation. And another thing is training. That doesn't just happen automatically. And for that reason, this Sunday, we will not have a live online experience at 10 o'clock. I know, put in the crying emojis, the sad emojis. We're doing that for a few reasons. Number one, we need to prepare and train people. Right now, we have three people that are learning our system. We have some new things in place, which we're excited about because you are so important. And so we have to train. That takes time. It takes learning as well. But also, we need more volunteers. And so this is a cry for you. If you're impacted by this online ministry, if you want to be used by God to reach people, you don't even know where to start, and don't be intimidated by by the things. Because like I said, one of the reasons we're not going live this Sunday at 10 o'clock is so we can train. And so that's you. If you want to be used and you want to get plugged in, please let us know ASAP. We need to train, we need to pour in, because the quality of the service that we want to give Jenny is one of excellence. Our King deserves our excellence. And so this Sunday, we will not be live at 10 o'clock. However, we will put the message out there, maybe a song or two, some announcements out there at a later time on Sunday. And so in the coming days, I'll let you know what time that's going to be. But at 10 o'clock, you will not have a live service from Vision. And so I know that disappoints you, but you can just prepare for an afternoon worship service. And so it'll be just the same. We're really working on it. And just know the reason we're doing this is for you. Because when we go live, we want God to be glorified in whatever we put out there. So again, no online broadcast at 10. And so that, what does that mean? That means you need to come.
That's right.
Right, just come.
That's right.
And get ready, because the best is yet to come.